Who are we addressing here? Is this America? Are we speaking to America or the World Wide Web?
The World Wide Web.
Hello, America and the good people of the World Wide Web. I am Matt Booth, and this is my very dear friend, Robert Rosewood Rosadelic Caldwell. We are here today to show you some of our new fine smokables. We're here at the Ipsipper 2017 in Las Vegas.
And
what we decided to do essentially is do a little collaborative effort, put forth a collaborative effort between the two of us and another dear friend of ours to make a sort of
maniacal three-way collaborative
project. Now, with that said,
I think I will begin
with this one, because this is shipping now. It's very current, very fresh, very, very right now in the moment. This is manufactured in the Dominican with pride by the artisans at the William Ventura factory.
Out of the way, that guy.
Oh, yes. That's been a man in sports.
On the left.
He has had his hands in the mix on these products. And this is the filler composition is Dominican. The origin of the binder is Indonesia, and the wrapper is from Ecuador. This is a very pleasant and sophisticated smoking experience.
I would say medium to medium plus body in nature, with a full flavor that is
clean on the finish, but yet exciting at the same time.
No?
Okay. Was that good?
That was great. Okay, good.
The next project I will highlight is made in Nicaragua by my dear friend Adrian
Freddy
Fernandez. Freddy, shout out to Freddy, the consigliere of AJ Fernandez. This is going to be an all Nicaraguan smoking experience, full body, good spice, clean on the finish, rockstar of a cigar. Okay, made by the mad genius of manufacturing himself, AJ Fernandez. This is going to be shipping in September 2017. If you want some stickers, take some stickers. Have the stickers. How are you? Do you have questions?
What do you got going on?
What do you got going on?
Okay. No, we're doing cigars and stuff.
Yeah.
What have you guys
cigars
been up
and things.
To?
We've been writing about cigars.
Who else have you interviewed today?
I don't even remember.
Would it be safe to say we were your only interview today?
No, not
me. So that would be false.
Yeah.
So we're not special at all.
You're all special. Depending on the context of special.
Uh-huh. I see. That's cool. Where are you guys from?
I'm from Colorado, Denver.
Okay, Denver. My sister used to live in Aurora.
Yeah, I used to live in Aurora too.
Very nice. You also?
I'm from Iowa.
Nice. Okay.
Yep.
That's cool.
Yep.
How do you guys know each other?
Internet. There's six of us here total.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you all meet online?
Yes.
You all started, right?
Yeah. We're all spread out.
Okay.
Throughout the country.
Is that are you like alluding to something, or are you just saying distance wise?
Distance wise.
Okay, I got you. I just want to check. I just want to confirm. We want to get all the facts.
Yeah, yeah.
So you enjoy Robert Caldwell's products?
Obviously.
Which is your favorite?
Yeah, which one's your favorite?
Yeah, Blind Man's Bluff, of course.
What about it? What do you like about it?
Because it took our name.
Not really, but kind of.
Yeah, a little.
But on accident.
Yeah,
it was kismet, man.
Right.
It was meant to be.
Kismet.
Yeah, it was meant to be.
Blind Man's Bluff.
Yeah. And
that was actually a backup name. The real name was Savages. No.
I have a box.
It was Vandals.
Vandals, okay.
Oh, that's cool.
That's sick.
That is dope.
There's another guy that makes cigars that has an online seasonal size that's called the Dirty Something Vandal. Therefore, I didn't want to get sued.
Understood.
And I changed it. But
understood.
Vandals is nasty, because that's why it's vandalized.
Yeah. No, it's fresh. I like that.
Amazing. That's Mario's name. Mario came up with
that. Okay. I like it.
Mario's not.
Have you met Mario?
Mario's got shits.
Yes.
He's got diarrhea.
Oh, no. He's got Nicaragua, but
yeah, he's got Nicaragua.
I get it. So he imported.
He's been
that
in the hotel, like he was sick all day yesterday.
Wow, he's just been on the can
27 times yesterday.
Yo,
27.
Was he like carving lines on the wall?
Drew a statement.
entrance, the U.
Oh.
Look at the creative genius.
Hey, hey, wait a minute. Jacqueline, let's talk about, let's talk about some All Out Kings packaging right here. We got the All Out Kings people.
That, I'd like to highlight, I'd actually like to highlight some.
How are you? It's good to see you.
How's things, boss?
Awesome.
That's All Out Kings.
So Jacqueline is actually the creative genius that, I mean, it was with a bit of art direction, per se, if you will, that created this fine piece of artwork that you see as the centerpiece. I feel that this piece is the proper communication. It truly emotes the passion that Robert and I share for not only cigars in general, but for one another. And so we have it as a centerpiece. But Jacqueline,
where's she? Jacqueline, come over here. Jacqueline.
See?
Gotcha now.
Jacqueline used to work for Caldwell, and then she left us and went to Drew Estate. She's a traitor. Jacqueline, come here.
Stole her.
How do you feel about how this... Joey, how do you feel about
sorry,
this?
Thief. Sorry. Interview. This is going to be the greatest video of the show, yeah. I guarantee it.
This is...
Jacqueline, come here.
This is deteriorated quickly.
No, it's... Yeah. No, sorry. I think it's why did you let better. Him
okay.
Why did you let him have that?
But good. That's good.
I really just took it.
Thief, look at him stealing more shit.
I know. I'm looking at it.
Well, no, man. I mean, they had all these questions. Well,
that's Tony.
He started interviewing me.
Tony owns La Barba.
La Barba. And
then Tony, why don't you talk about La Barba?
There.
You're going to have to lower, get to lower the,
focus on his nose hair.
What about La Barba?
Now, Tony's not only a pretty face, he also makes some amazing cigars, right?
Correct.
Fair enough.
Well, were you talking about pretty faces earlier?
I was saying you're not just a pretty face. You also
correct.
Make a great cigar.
Same with you and same with him.
Are you hitting on me or you just stating?
All. Awesome.
All of the above.
Awesome. So bad.
You should interview Tony.
Interview me. So, Tony.
Yes.
Well, first of all, do you have any shout-outs for anybody in America? Otherwise, it's going to go on the worldwide web, obviously.
For posting. Just Maddie Cupcakes.
Okay, shout-out Maddie Cupcakes.
Yeah. You know, Brian from
East Nippon. My stores.
There you go. Okay.
Garrett.
Especially Gino.
Yeah. Yeah, of course, yeah, Gino.
Because he's very web savvy, so I'm sure he'll be.
He's the patriarch of the Havana House family.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Correct.
So, LaBarba, how did you come up with LaBarba anyways? Why did you name it LaBarba?
Well, we were sitting around and big round table. Look at this camera work. You are.
It's professional.
Then you did.
Is this rolling?
Yeah, I'll edit it later.
Okay. Your cool arrow was real close to that.
Thank
that
you.
Cigar,
man.
I thought. I mean,
do you want to identify yourself for the kids? Because we were talking about something, I feel like they should hear it.
I'm Donnie from Akron, Ohio, Cigar Lodge.
Akron's in the house.
Absolutely. Represent. So, but yeah, I loved that stuff. You know, the old school
stuff.
The original was my favorite cigar of all time. Okay. The one you did with Hoyle.
Okay.
And then I thought the Coolero was damn close to it, in my opinion.
It's a tasty Coolero.
It was.
Yeah.
Which means cheap asshole, right? In Spanish.
It's a little deeper than that.
A little deeper than that. Well, yeah. I understand the roots from it. But.
Can we swear on this or no?
Absolutely.
It kind of means Captain Buttfucker.
Captain Buttfucker. Okay. There you go. Yeah.
I mean, if it's said quickly, if not.
Yeah.
Then it's just English, yeah. And it's cool, and arrow.
There you go, yep.
Simple.
Yeah, which a buddy of mine, funny story about that, was a buddy of mine is like, he works with a bunch of Spanish guys down in Texas, wow. And he's like,
Spaniards.
Yeah, and he would say, Spaniards, and they would always say, if they hated one of the foremen or something, they would tell him he was a cool arrow, and he thought he was, you know, like, he'd be like, thank you, you know? And so every time I see that cigar, I think of that damn story, you know?
Thank you.
Awesome.
That works.
Yeah,
I appreciate your time, your candor, and your honesty.
Very cool. Nice meeting you.
Pleasure.
That's Tony.
Yes.
I will see you shortly.
Yeah. Stop in.
Yeah.
When are you there?
Let's look at the activity. Craig.
Hello, Matt. How are you?
What's up, guys?
It's nice to see you.
How's it going? How are you feeling about the show? How's everything going?
I'm doing well.
So, what is this? Is this like a
Postman Blue? Yeah, Postman Blue. Yeah. Classic. This is awkward. You're not even shooting me. I appreciate it.
I am shooting you. Look at you. You're right there. Look at
this. This is super awkward. Oh, God.
Cigar business.
I'll take it.
Hey, a little bit.
definitely a phenomenal cigar. Very, very, very tasty cigar. We don't have samples of it, but it really, I think, is one of the cases.
This is commerce taking place for us.
What's going on?
This is FaceTiming with daughter taking place right now.
There you go. I'll leave you to
that. We got Montanez in the building.
Matt, hello.
Recording him. You know what it is, man. All day.
How are you?
Damn, he's loud. I'm joking. What's good, man?
What are you doing?
I've been in the camera all day, man. This is Robert Caldwell.
He just started making cigars this year. He's new to the game.
That's not even funny. None of this is funny. It's terrible. Keep walking, man.
Okay, keep
Rob is a hater.
Yeah. Rob, do it.
2 for 5. You can follow the yellow grinder.
Matt.
This is Robert Caldwell's signature smile.
Follow the yellow grinder, everyone.
Okay, now, Tony, I'm sorry. So,
you were caught up in a great enchanting conversation.
It was enchanting. I was enchanted. So, this is Tony again. This is Craig. He's parked there.
Craig, thank you.
I don't know why I like that song. It's just fun. It's fun.
It's weird because you don't, and it's funny.
And he's a dick because he yells it like as I'm walking by.
Craig,
and he yells it, but not like, hey, I want to tell you something. Just, I'm going to annoy you while you walk by and get your attention so you stop.
I just want you I want your gaze to fall.
That's wonderful.
Yeah. So
I was saying, let's get back to the book.
Yes.
This is important for the kids.
What was the genesis of the creation of the name LeBron? Why so snippy?
So, as you know, naming a company or a cigar is a lot like naming a band. You have everybody together.
Right.
You get the cigar.
Right.
We'd have a name.
I got you, right?
So, we spent many nights on Craig's back porch smoking and trying to decide on something. We had a million names. They all sucked.
Ketamine.
Yes. And do peyote.
Right, there you go. So, you vision quested to get the
name. We vision quested to get the name.
Buttons. How was that?
It's great.
So how did this what ended up happening?
So in the trip.
Yeah.
We were kind of looking around and we were like, what makes us different? Like, what makes us unique? Why is La Barba unique in the marketplace? And it's kind of like...
But you didn't have the name.
We didn't have the name.
No. So you're saying what makes La Barba... You're saying what makes this cigar unique?
This cigar unique, not La Barba at this point.
Just check.
Party foul. So we're looking around and we were thinking about like the rite of passage for the barbershop. You know, when you turn 18.
Right.
You know, you go to the cigar shop and the barbershop. Learn how to swear in a barbershop, learn about girls in the barbershop, all your bad habits, barbershop, drinking. Same with cigar shops, right? Kind of is that transition into manhood, something that is.
So speaking of that, so like I was always under the impression that this had some sort of reference to what the actor position is.
No.
Not at all.
No.
So it's kind of like
a I wonder where you heard that from. Where did you hear that from? Where did that start at?
No,
who's Patient Zero?
I believe Patient Zero is standing behind the camera.
Yeah. Velvet Jones.
Velvet Jones.
Yes.
So this the basic idea here is that all these bands,
all these good areas,
it's a rite of passage. Yeah, learned. It's like a rite of passage thing, you know. When did you start smoking cigars? Okay. Was it a rite of passage? Did you then? Were you bonding? Did you bond with your uncle?
I did.
Yeah. It's kind of like a rite of passage. Something that like brings you through. Yeah. Kind of like getting circumcised. Also, that usually happens at a younger age than cigar smoking. For some.
You never really see another.
But we all, you know, it's like, look at how you wear your lovely.
Is that a goatee?
Is that a goatee?
Facial hair.
What would you call that thing? It is. You are. You're very pointy.
Thank you.
It does draw it out.
Very pointy.
Like you secretly have.
Get the point. Get the point. Get the point.
You have a really wide face, and this is how.
And this is how I elongate.
You remember?
Yeah. That's how I elongate.
The Moon Man at McDonald's. He's supposed to.
I do actually. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
incarnate. Nice. You are the moon man.
Nice. He was a little creepy, no?
I smell a new cigar brand out of that.
The moon man of Akron.
Yes. Moon man of
So anyways, so how long have you been doing, how long has La Barba been active, an active brand?
2012.
God. God has spoken.
So 2012, La Barba launched.
Yes.
How many lines? How many lines? Let's get through the breakdown. Your favorite.
Wait, do we ever get to the name?
Oh, yeah. How did, no, it's the rite of passage.
Rite of passage. Yeah. So we're looking around. We both did.
Yeah, together.
I was looking at him.
That and the band, like the razor blade.
Yeah, we love
same time.
The concept of the straight razor, which has become the icon, the brand.
Correct. So. Correct. You see that and you know La Barba.
Yeah.
And that's why we changed the labels. Obviously, the cigar rings are now more
on the icon side,
so the blade is bigger. Blade is bigger.
Wait, hold on. Wait, focus. Focus it. No, you. Yeah.
There you go.
Oh, look at it. That's a cool photo. Can you look at it? That's great. Look at that. Nice. Craig, you're so serious.
He is a very
serious
man.
So intense.
Very intense.
Well, yeah, so we started with 2012. We finally got the name. The straight razor logo. We were off to the proverbial races. So started with Corojo Tobacco. All of our cigars are made by... I don't know where he went. The lovely Henderson Ventura.
He's around.
And Mr. Rossi and I have known Robert for quite some time. And where I was doing all the distribution out of my store, things got crazy. Selling out of cigars, selling out of cigars, selling out of cigars. Retailers were unhappy with me. So we went to Rob.
Wherever he went.
And